Yesterday, Parliament passed the Fisheries and Aquaculture Bill 2021 to step up regulation in the fishing sector that has been grappling with bad fishing. The Minister of State for Fisheries, Helen Adoa, has spoken out on the bill as a key milestone that is going to restore sanity in the sector.
The law basically is highlighting the issues of management of fisheries. Two, it is looking at the fish products, because the issue of fish maw has come up now, which never used to be an item, and now everyone is rushing for fish maw and abandoning the fish, which brings the fish more. So there is need to regulate.
Parliament scrapped off the two licenses that have been bothering fishermen, like licenses to individual people that carry out fishing, which was shifted to fishing boats, licensing fish storage facilities, which was also rejected by Parliament, which has excited MPs representing fishing communities.
One of them is the individual permit. After that, for every person to fish, you must have a special license where you pay 25,000 every year. We looked at the rationale behind this, and since it is to control fisheries activities, you can actually do that through licensing the boats as opposed to licensing people.
The new bill created the Fishery Surveillance Unit to replace the notorious Fisheries Protection Unit of the Army. The unit will be made up of personnel trained by police to enforce good fishing practices.
It is a police force that is going to handle operations on the lake, especially training those people that will have been gotten to survey the lake.
I like empowering the FPUs, the Army, the Fisheries Protection Force to enforce law. We scrutinized it and did real surgery into this bill. Almost 80% of the clauses were changed to see that we make it to see that we harmonize it to fit into the interests of a local Ugandan.
The amendment also decentralized fishing regulatory services to district level by creating positions of district fisheries officers to reduce powers of the chief fisheries officer at the ministry. Although this has excited legislators, the Minister of State for Fisheries, Helen Adoa, has expressed fears that it will not be easy for the Ministry of Fisheries to coordinate with district fisheries officers who are not answerable to the Ministry of Fisheries but to their hosting districts.
But also, when you look at the law right now, the district fisheries officer is answerable to local government. So that is where things may not be very good. We at the fisheries headquarters or directorate may not be able to control too much what is happening down when they have given powers, because people like conniving.
MPs have also welcomed the decision by Parliament to trim powers of the Minister of Fisheries over the fishing sector. The law now requires the minister to submit all regulations of the fishing sector to Parliament for approval.
So all those who have made it a guarantee that the districts, the local governments, shall have overall powers to dictate on when to gazette a fishing landing site, when to close or announcing a fishing holiday, and also the entire registration and the regulations of their fisheries activities have been put into the hands of a local Ugandan, so that we avoid the monopoly and the oligopoly which was identified within the principal bill as it has been.
The new law has also legalized the trade of fish maw in the country by providing for the new licensing regime for fish maw trade.
In the new bill, we have provided for trade in fish maw, because in the old bill, this wasn't mentioned at all. So it was like an illegality.
Parliament also revised penalties for bad fishing practices and relaxed reasonable fines and sentences that are enforced by law.
For 200 million, we are reduced to 40 million. Those to 100 million, we are reduced to 20. But also the duration, in the case one is imprisoned. Those were for 5 years, were reduced to 3. Those for 3 were reduced to 10.
Story by Fred Kajibi for the news at Parliament.